sound okay. I am sure that all of you had talked with your friends in the past about what the future would be like. I always knew that we'd be able to watch TV on our phones. What about a self-cleaning robot? These were the things we talked about. Recently, a French artwork from the 19th century about the 2000s would look like was released recently, and most of the things in the artwork has been invented now. But there's one that we still haven't been able to figure out. It's a machine that allows us to automatically receive information and knowledge. Well, I guess studying was hated back then as much as it is today. How about you? What did you imagine for the future? Welcome to Sound K, and I'm your DJ, Stephanie. I seriously thought that music was over and I was about to say the next thing, but oh, it wasn't. Anyways, welcome back, everyone. You're listening to Sound K, and I'm your DJ, Stephanie. Today is Wednesday. Happy Wednesday, everyone. October 7th, 2015. And the first song of Sound K was Speed Up by Melody Day. Never thought of Melody Day with that energetic, powerful song. And Yeon got a lot of popularity because she appeared on that music show, which is Mask King, right? The variety show, which is, they're covered with this like a huge mask, and in the panels, they try to figure out who's who. But anyways, they are back, and I actually enjoyed that song. Well, the last part was, I did not see that coming, but yeah, I totally really am in love with that song. Anyways, let's talk about tonight's intro. So I do have the list of the French artwork from the 19th century about what the 2000, which is 21st century, would look like. So the painters who assumed, I'm actually putting in the easy words, who assumed about what's gonna look like in 21st century. Well, this was way back in 19th century. So here we go. First was cleaning robot. I was sharing about that self-cleaning robot. And these days, you can even get it from internet. Yes. Second, farming machine. Yes for that. Third, machines that make clothes. So, when you measure things, you know, there's a sewing machine, but we do have some kind of machines that puts the clothes together. Yeah, like stitches and everything. So, yes, like 80%, 7%. And fourth was studying machine in a human brain, which I was just sharing about that the machine that allows us to automatically receive information and knowledge. Fifth was flying taxi. Flying taxi. I wish we can invent that. Flying taxi. And sixth is the music constructor who plays every instrument. So basically, when you go to performance, there's a music constructor who plays violin, piano, and just everything at once. Well, that was a little cute one, but that's almost impossible because we still like to hear all the instruments, and there are a lot of experts who can actually play that gorgeous instrument, amazing sounds, and people do enjoy it, you know? Anyways, a lot of them we see nowadays, but machines that allows us to automatically receive information and knowledge, that I don't know if we ever gonna have that in the future too. If the machine can do it for us, there's no point of studying. Well, which means a lot of students will be free from stress, but yet studying and learning, that's part of our life, right? It is something that essential thing in our lives. So, I'm not saying I'm against that, but that might be very interesting, because if we just like put the chips or some kind of machine inside our brain and everyone is like so smart, I don't know what's gonna happen, but it sounds amazing, but I don't know. As you know, as a human being, I think learning from like making mistakes, I think that's part of fun in life. Anyways, I gave you the question, and that was the list that we actually got from the research. So that was that. And the question was, what did you imagine for the future when you're younger? Let me know, okay? Or I know a lot of our listeners are still very young, so in the future, what do you see? What do you imagine of? Let me know, okay? So send in your feedback message on our message board, or you can also say hello. Any updates or your country's news that you want to share, please send them in. I would love to share with SK family. And of course, this is how you can participate on our message board. If you're on Jeju-do Island, our FM frequencies are 80.7 in Jeju City, 80.1 in Seokgyeopup City, 101.9 MHz in Daejeong area. And you can also find us on TDMB Arirang Radio. If you have a smartphone, you can download our application that is available for both iPhone and, of course, Android operation systems. And be sure to check us out on Twitter and Facebook as well. Also, feel free to send us your comments, messages, questions on our website. It is www.arirangradio.com/soundk. Let's listen to the next track. Ooh, this is the new one. This is I by Taeyeon featuring Verbal Gent. Come on. Quiz. Are you guys ready for tonight's daily quiz? And here is the question, so listen very carefully. This female artist with her cute looks and fantastic vocals is releasing her new song tomorrow. Her new song, Mianeo, I'm Sorry, is a ballad that will completely show off her amazing vocal range. And it was originally supposed to be her debut song, but she instead released a sweet dance song, 예뻐졌다, Beautiful, and 연애할래, Sella Pretty. Through her album songs, she not only released ballads, but also songs that she personally wrote herself. And this song, 미안해요, I'm Sorry, will show her musical development. This singer was discovered on the survival audition program Superstar K Season 2 and released her debut song Beautiful last August. Which female solo artist is releasing her song 미안해요, I'm Sorry tomorrow? Number 1, 이하이. Number 2, 박보람. Number 3, 백예린. Once more. Number 1, 이하이. Number 2, 박보람. Number 3, 백예린. So now accept only the answers on our message board. And this time, we do have Between's signed CD. So be sure to leave us your answers on our quiz and answer board. We have Paulina from the UK saying, hello. Good evening, sweet DJ. Hello. Long time no see, Paulina. I missed you so much. So yes, Dirty, I sent you the small parcel. Oh, is that right? The package for your birthday next week. Oh my goodness, you did not say that. Really? I cannot believe it. I hope you like it, and I don't it's going to be go on a time, but it's okay. Well, I didn't mention anything about my birthday, but oh, thank you, Paulina. It's really surprising. Have a great show. Lots of love, Paulina from the UK. As always, thank you very much for supporting. Wow, you literally just my day. And we have Harshika from Sri Lanka saying, hello, Ani. Hi. Hope you are doing great. Happy Wednesday. I wish I would get a signed CD of you in the future. So that was the intro feedback. Oh, that's so cute. If I could. 사랑해요, 언니. I love you. The thing is, since I'm releasing my new album, it's gonna be mini album. I told you guys that. And I am sure that I'm going to bring severals, because last time for, with my digital single, I couldn't do that because since I didn't have a physical CD, this time I'm going to bring it for sure. Okay. So in the future, but, yeah, I think it's gonna be, it will come true. Okay. Anyways, guys, I asked you the question. I'm going to repeat, so please send in the feedback message or you can also participate for the daily quiz answers. Okay, here's the question. What did you imagine for the future? Or what are you imagining for the future? Well, vice versa. Okay, let me know. Send in your feedback message. I'll be waiting for it. Now, let's take a listen to two more tracks. First song is K-drama by Woo Hyo. Second song is Wing Wing by Hyogo. We listened to two amazing tracks. Welcome back, everyone. You're listening to Sound K, and I'm your DJ, Stephanie. Let's share some more messages. We have Amira from Algeria saying, I would love to share with this with SK family. Hello, SK family. Hello, Amira. This is Amira from Algeria, and today I want to share my sad story with you. Uh-oh. Last year, I began to learn Korean language here in Algeria, in King Sejong Institute, and I was very happy about that because it was my dream and my friend's dream as well. That class meant a lot to us. It was where we first met with some of the greatest people in our lives. We made friendship with the others who shared the same passion. And made some unforgettable memories with our teachers who were super nice with us. But unfortunately, we faced a big problem this year. Our teacher said that the institute decided to close here in Algeria and it will be no more Korean class. Oh, it was a shocking news for most of us because we had a lot of expectation about the class. And to some of us, it was related to our future, and it was the place where we forget about our hardships and busy life in another way, our own world or our small paradise. Our teacher tried her best and still trying her best to not closing the class, and we are still waiting any news about it. We all feel sad and pray to not close it. Please hope for us that it will open up soon. And thanks for listening. Well, Amira from Algeria, thank you very much for sharing that. Because even though it was a random, that's like an update. And I just love to share this kind of story. So first of all, that's very unfortunate. And at one point, I was very happy that actually our Algerian fans, like a K-popers, you guys have a chance to learn our language. That's huge. And opening up the academy in a foreign country, that might be very hard for the teachers to do. And I don't know what really is going on. It seems like you guys don't know either, but maybe the company trying to not tell you guys the details because it might be sadder. So for now, let's wait a little. We'll pray. But Amira, if you want to learn like Korean, there are a lot of different channels, and especially in the Arirang broadcast, that's what we do. We actually am trying to be this bridge between in like a connecting Korea and like worldwidely. So if you have any question, you can ask me. But for now, since you really love that classes and plus the academy, hope that Korean academy or the classes can be opened again so you guys can attend. Let's pray for Amira, everyone. And once more, thank you very much for sharing that. We have a Chorok from Korea saying, hello, happy Wednesday. So, midnight, the show next week, I saw it. And high expectation. Because at the end, I saw this very pretty, handsome human being walking. And it was my heart flutter. Really, you're gonna do this to me? Thank you very much for giving me a power and an energy. I'm supporting you. 힘내고 fighting. Love you. Okay, so I did not realize that. So I was on that there. Uh-huh. Well, thank you very much for letting me know because I did not know that. So everyone, yes, I'm coming back next week. Seems like I am appearing the show, that music program. So yeah. Well, next week is the big week and I am having this comeback stage and the show is live. So you can see me there, but it's next week. So, well, Chorok, thank you very much once more for sharing that. And Abla from Morocco saying, how are you, Stephanie? I'm very good. You look so good in red. Thank you. Stephanie, yesterday I watched the latest episode of Running Man. And at the end, they showed the preview for the next episode. And OMG, you're going to be in the Running Man's next episode. Yeah, this coming Sunday. Uh-huh. I am so excited to see you there. Well, a lot of girls appear there, so I'm just one of the guests. But I really was honored for me to be on that show because I met Yoo Jae-suk and Kim Jong-guk and Haha 10 years ago when I appeared X-Men. That was a long, long time ago. And they were pretty surprised. Because they saw me when I was 18 years old and now I'm like 29 and see what happens because it was pretty funny when we were shooting that show. But get excited, everyone. But for now, let's focus on our sound cake, okay? Thank you very much. Let's take a short music break and continue our show. This is Super Moon by Choi Ye-geun featuring Ildo of Ichonan.
Welcome. It's time for Sound K. Yeah. Alright, what's good, Stephanie? Take it over.
It is Wednesday. That means that we are going to invite Corey of 24K in our studio. So don't go anywhere. Start at 9 p.m. tonight. And for the start date, tomorrow, on Thursday, October 8th, we are going to invite the seven shining stars at Daya. They are going to be here on Soundcase, so please send in your supportive message for Daya. It is www.arirangradio.com/soundk. For other segment corners, on Tuesdays, we have Tell Me, Tell Me Season 2. And next week, we are going to have Angela once more for Leah's spot. So it's Big Shot and Angela, where we give you advice on anything and everything from score to love. And on Sundays, we let you, our listeners, to become the DJ of the night with my playlist. So please leave us one theme with three different song choices that you like to share with everyone. Don't forget to write in the reasons and a little bit of explanation why you chose all those three different songs. Keep those messages coming on our message board. Let's move on to this or that. You know, I'm always curious about our listeners. So through this or that question, I will get to know you little by little. You guys know that I always come up with a question that's kind of related to intro. And since we were talking about robot, I do have a question. So tonight, this or the question is... Option 1, the robot that takes your order. Option 2, the robot that accompanies you. It's different. So first, robot that takes your order. So such as you actually are like the boss. You're hiring this. It's like employee. So it's like go do something. So you're ordering them. Second, being friend. Like robot that can accompany you. That can talk to and you can show the emotional feelings and or just you can just cry, like lean on it, so something like that. So first will be robot that takes your order, and second, robot that accompanies you. Let me know. Send in your feedback message with the title, this or that. So now we've got some feedbacks. Chaha from Korea saying, I really wish that people can invent thoughts organizer. So, like a thoughts organizing robot. Whenever I try to write, I think, and double it up because I think too much. There's too many thoughts going on, and sometimes I cannot organize my own thoughts. That happens. Yeah, and that's very normal. So I want this robot that's connected to my nervous system and trash all those negative thoughts. That's a very good idea. So when you can click and trash all that, throw away all that negative thoughts, that would be genius. I like that. And once when I try to write, if there is like a story that goes like a crazy, I want this organizer to organize my thoughts. And sometimes it's better for me to write with the hands. And while when I think and type it, sometimes I cannot organize. So all I wish to do is think. And think randomly, and this robot can organize the storyline. Well, you're an author, so that's very meaningful. Taha, thank you very much. That was genius. Hindun from Indonesia saying, DJ Stephanie, so you've been a DJ for a long time now, and you have read so many listeners' messages. Then can you guess their psychology conditions or their characters from their writing? Okay, so... here's the thing. I do read messages, and I do read the messages that sometimes that our listeners don't want me to say it on air. So it's like it can be very intimate conversation between me and our listeners, and I love about that. Sharing, and there's no like boundaries. And sometimes it's really thankful for me to receive the messages. I love hello messages. I'm not saying like, you know, and the feedback messages. But what I'm saying is I do talk more and more deep things with our listeners. So to answer your question, yes. But I don't really judge, and I don't like that word at all. I really don't like to judge. So whenever I receive a message, I don't really come up with like, oh, this person gonna be this or that. And I'm trying not to think psychological way because, you know, I'm not a psychologist. But sometimes I need to know, it's kind of my job to know what our listeners are going through. And I love to know things, and no begging though. It's like if our listeners want for me to know, then, you know, then the conversation and communicates. But as long as our listeners want to approach me first, I'm always open about hearing things. So yes or no, but psychologically, I don't really judge. So it's a little different category. But most of the times I know what is going on with our listeners, basically. So does that make sense? Hindun from Indonesia, well, thank you very much. She's so happy right now, or she must be so sad, something like that. So the emotional-wise, yes. Of course, I know. Yeah. Hindun, thank you very much for asking that question. Anyways, I just gave you the this or that question, everyone. Time is ticking. We have to listen to this track and come back. This is Beautiful by Heartbeat featuring And Up. Yes, everyone, that was a Thank You by Kavi and Jay featuring Tang Hyun, Misty, Chung Hae-min. I'm actually close at Misty, and she's been waiting for this moment for a long, long time. She's an incredible singer. She still sings. She released a single, I believe, and I interviewed her like almost a year and a half or 2 years ago. But now they're back as like a whole group. It's like of course it's a project, but it's like a reuniting. Love it. Anyways, for now we're going to share some this or that feedbacks, and if it can't read all of them, of course don't worry, I'll be sharing your message in the near future. We have Hershika from Sri Lanka saying, this or that feedback, the first robot is better. First robot first robot was, oh, takes your order. Oh, I see. So you want to become a boss. And Hindu from Indonesia saying, actually, I want to have a good-looking robot that could guard me. Oh, why not? But then I'm afraid that I will fall for him. Yeah. There's even a movie called Her. And what was her name? The gorgeous Hollywood star. I cannot really remember her name. But anyways, Scarlett Johansson. There you go. It's like she just, her voice disappears. But it was just very sexy. And this guy, you know, falls in love with this cell phone or device. So it's possible. There's a possibility. It will be so complicated then. So I just want to use a full robot that can take order. So there we go. And we have a Shreya from Bangladesh saying, I will choose robot who gives me a company. So the robot that can be your friend. Sometimes I feel lonely, so I need somebody who cheers me up all the time. And if I have a robot like a friend, that will be very awesome. Yeah. And I can play, I can share things that I want. So that is why I want a robot as a friend. Good idea, Shreya. Tom from Poland saying, I will go with the second one. Especially after you've expanded the tonight, though. Expanded the thoughts? Is that thoughts? And I don't know really why, but I thought of the movie Terminator 2 almost an instant. How the robot played the Arnold Schwarzenegger to care of young John Connor. Oh my goodness. And what Sarah Connor, the kid's mother, thought. Is that the robot will never get tired? Biases. Will never hit the kid. And that in the hard times shown in the movie, and that robot seemed like someone close to father to the kid, closest to the ideal. The technology is developing fast, and robots we are talking about might be something usual soon. So we should think of them as partners, co-workers, and not just a servant or slaves. Uh-huh. P.S. I love your new style, Stephanie. Lots of love. Tom, thank you very much. Whoo! My goodness, it's already our time to wrap up the first part of the show, but don't go anywhere because I will see you guys on part two. And the last song is Downtown Love by Chuyong featuring Meg, Clown, and Wayne. And see you guys on part two.